Welcome to Beyond the Press channel.
Hello!
Today we are going to do experiment. We have 10 kilograms of steel and our gas furnace. And then we have also 10 kilograms of dry ice.
Cold.
And we are going to heat the steel until it's red hot. And then we are going to place it on top of the dry ice. And we will see which one is going to win.
Red hot versus white cold.
And I haven't done any calculations as usual. But I think that the dry ice is going to win. Because usually when you are like, when matter is changing its state, like melting or, I think the word is sublimate or something like that with the dry ice, because it turns from solid straight to gas, and that takes much more energy than just like changing temperature on the steel. So I think the dry ice is going to win. This is Anni's opinion.
I think red hot will win.
I think I will win and wife will lose.
As always.
Yeah, but let's heat up the steel. So we already filmed the extra content for today's video
while waiting.
Let's have a look how hot the thing is now. Not even close. Dry ice versus molten lake. Pretty interesting. I think when we have done the actual experiment for today's video, we are going to dump the rest of the dry ice into lake.
Yeah.
That's going to be interesting. It is really cold.
Yeah, I feel it.
Yeah, I think that is enough. Yep, here it comes. Holy shit, it's hot!
And red.
Oh
my. Wait, let's check.
How? What the fuck? It's not doing anything. Really interesting, huh? I thought that there is some kind of explosion or something and we have to run. But it's not doing anything. Our thermal camera is completely confused what is going on. This is a bit too much for it. And when you are here, you cannot feel the cold because the cold doesn't radiate away. It just like sucks heat from you. But this, in the other hand, this radiates really much. And you cannot tell that there is anything cold. You just feel the heat from this. This is pretty good because my...
It's going through.
Yeah, it's sinking there. Slowly but surely. I think that most of the heat is going to the iron, not to the dry ice. I think it's now gone through like maybe two or three layers. Let's see what happens if I add some water.
Uh-oh. It's like sound.
Yeah, I think that, yeah, the steel like boils the water away and it didn't have any chances of freezing. And seems that the whole steel is falling. I try to bit adjust it. Holy shit, it's almost through. I flip it on the other side. The thermal camera isn't knowing anything. It has been 12 minutes now. I think the steel is maybe going to win this, Anni.
I know.
Because it's really hot. What the fuck? Let's have a look.
Of course.
It's gone through! What the?
Yep.
And it's
almost red!
Actually, it was color from the brick, but it is still really hot. So the red hot steel went through all of that without any problems. It's still stupidly hot. I check on my gear. Yeah, this says over 150 still. Do we have infrared meter on our car?
No, we don't have,
so we cannot measure it. But I dip this into the lake. So let's have a look how hot it is. Can you film this?
Yeah.
So here it goes. Yeah, it's...
That sound. Oh, warm steam.
There is shitload of energy in this. Let's see now, I think it's still over 150. No, now it's 100. It was on the top, it was below 150. Or actually the inside of the steel is still really hot. And because of that, it like heats up again from the... Holy shit! I was almost in the lake. Yeah. Yeah, I think we are not going to cool down this because we have one more video that we are going to film now. So I'm going to throw that back into here. For the next video. But yeah, the red hot steel wins, dry ice lose.
No, I win, husband lose.
Yeah, and now we have that extra experiment. What happens when... Let's throw these here. Yeah, thermal camera doesn't understand the situation at all. Yeah, I think this is actually maybe even more interesting than the original idea of the video. And be sure to check the extra content, it's really great also. Yeah, I think that is all for today.
Thank you for watching.
And have a nice day.
And for today's extra content, some slow motion stuff with our new Kronos. The old camera that we had was prototype, and this is from like production series. So it's a bit nicer. And there was also some prototype problems with our old camera, so we have now better slow motion videos coming. And the old camera is going to back to David from Kron Technologies, and he is going to convert that to black and white camera. So then we have one color camera and one faster black and white machine. Yeah, but here is some dry ice explosions. Thank you.